Hello and welcome. In this video, we'll be showing you how to use the Reports feature on the Croptracker desktop platform. Croptracker generates many useful reports that will help keep your records up to date and in compliance with GAAP and labor regulations in your area. It is important to have clear records for audits and to ensure accountability in all areas of production. Croptracker takes the hassle out of accurate record keeping. To see all the reports available for you to generate, click on the Reports button at the top of the screen from the dashboard. The number of reports you have available to generate is dependent on the modules you've purchased. This demo account has all of the modules, so here you are able to see all the reports Croptracker can make. We are always adding new reports as we learn more about the needs of our clients. If you have questions about what reports will suit your needs, or if you need a report that's not on our list, please contact us at support@croptracker.com. To start, click on the report you would like to see, and it will prompt you to fill in the required information. Many reports will ask for a date range or a lot number, so make sure you have that information when generating your report. In this video, we'll show you three frequently used reports to give you an idea of what Croptracker can do. First, we'll take a look at a spray record report. Specify which sprays you would like to see using the filters at the left side of the screen. You can see the spray history of a specific crop by selecting the block or crop type. You can further specify by date, growth stage, pest, chemical, spray reason, responsible person, or applicator. Much of this information is optional, and you do not need to fill in all the information to generate report. You can use this report for a variety of things, including calculating how much of a certain chemical to reorder for next season, confirming you've met the treatment plans for a specific crop, and to ensure environmental and safety protocols are being met. The second report we will show is the employee timesheet report. This report is very useful for compiling information to send to an outside payroll company or for doing payroll yourself. It compiles hourly rates and piecework rates together as needed and ensures you are paying your employee in accordance with applicable labor regulations. From here, you can specify the search by using the filters on the left-hand side of the screen. You can select a date range and an employee to find out all areas they have worked during that time. You can also select multiple employees. You can specify the type of work done using the category and production practice filters. Additionally, you can specify the work done by block using the map or the list of blocks. These reports will display the piece rate as well as the hourly rate of pay. For more information on setting up pay rates and pay schedules, please check the video links in the description. The last report we'll show you today is the mock recall report. This report tracks a product all the way through your production line. To run this report, you will need the pack lot number of the product you wish to trace and a date range. You can see the pack lot number for any pack in your field pack event on the dashboard. Enter the lot number and the date range in the fields on the left. It may take a few moments to generate. From here, you can see everything that has happened to this product, including when it happened, who applied treatments, harvested or packed it, and where it was stored and shipped. If you hover over the lines displayed on the right, you can see specific information about each stage of the product. You can trace contents from planting to delivery and see who planted, harvested, and packed everything. This report makes it easy for you or an auditor to trace backwards and forward to see any information you want on a product. Finally, we'll go over how to send the information from the reports to wherever you need it. To email the report, select the Email button at the bottom of the right side information column and fill in the email address. The report will be attached to the email as a PDF. You can also save the report as a PDF, an Excel sheet, or a CSV file. This concludes our reports video. If you have any questions, check out the knowledge base links in the description. And as always, thanks for watching!